Okay, these types of questions confuse a lot of students. Here is the reason why. We are given the derivative graph, and then we are going to answer the questions about the original. And this is the typical calculus one question that you really, really have to know. All right, we have two questions, and let's just focus on the first one. So first, we are going to find the interval for the original function f to be increasing. But remember, we are not given the original graph, okay? If you are given the original graph, then what you see is what you get. But here is the derivative graph. You have to think about the connection. Here's the connection, I'll tell you. If you want f to be increasing from the derivative, that means f prime has to be greater than zero. Positive first derivative will tell you that the original function is increasing. But here, we are given the graph of the derivative. So this means greater than zero, we are looking for what? We are looking for above the x-axis. So we're looking for the interval that the function is above the x-axis, which is this right here, right? That part of the graph is above the x-axis. And now let's see, it's from 1 to 5. So that's the answer for that. And remember, it's the open interval. So we just say 1 to 5, done. Now, f is decreasing. Well, just the opposite. We want the first derivative to be negative, and that's just below the x-axis. And we're two places, right? This part and also that part. For the first part, it's from 0 to 1, right? So from 0 to 1. And then the other part, it's from 5 to 6. By the way, I'm using union. If you check out the answer in the back of the book, they use comma, doesn't really matter. All right, now we are looking for the local maximum of f. And again, this is the original. So do not say the x is 3, right? That's not the, this point right here, it's not the local maximum of the original. And the reason is because we are given the derivative graph. So, how can we do it? Remember the first derivative test. In order for us to get local max of the original, f prime must changes from positive to negative, so that it will tell you the function is increasing to decreasing. You have a local max like that. And remember, positive first derivative means above the x-axis, and then negative is below the x-axis. From positive to negative, it's just like you are a swimmer, you are diving into the water. Right here, at x equal to 5. Right? At x equal to 5. Similarly, if you want to get a local minimum, well, f prime, the first derivative, it has to change from negative to positive. So remember, the x-axis right here is just like the water, right? And then in this case, below the water to above the water. So it's just like you are a flying fish. You're jumping out of the water at x equal to 1, and you're done, right? So that's that. Now, go ahead. Here we have another question. Try this first, right? Try this first before you watch the solutions. Done? All right, let's see. F is increasing. Again, we are given the first derivative graph. So we're looking for the places that it's above the x-axis, right? So we have it here and also right here. The first interval from 0 to 1. And the next interval is from 5 to 7. Okay. And then let's just erase this. Now, F is decreasing. That means it's below the x-axis. So it's all this part from 1 to 5, and then from 7 to 8. And you do not include the endpoints, right? You just don't include the endpoints for this kind of questions from 7 to 8. Even though when x is 8, it's like, hey, that's like negative 2, right? But like, no, you just don't include the endpoints for this kind of questions. Okay, local max of f. So how to do it? Local max, when we are given the first derivative, what do we do? It's just like you are diving into the water, right? So it's at 7. You're jumping into the water. And if you are a swimmer, if you dive, let me know. Right? So 7. X equals 7. So give the X value. Eh? And then local min. How do we do it? Oh, sorry. There's another one. We dive here, right? 1, 2. So two of them. So X equals 1. And the other one, X equals 7. We have two answers for that. Now for the local minimal, you are jumping out from the water, just like a flying fish. It's like you have a fish right here, and then, well, that's like a other direction, sorry. It's like you have a fish like this. No, that's a horrible looking fish. Just give me a, yeah. And then it's like jumping out of the water, yeah? So X equals 5. Okay. I'm gonna leave the fish for you guys on the screen. But yeah, make sure you guys know these kind of questions very, very well.